We are from EQ Magazine and today we have Mr. Krish Mukherjee with us from Sova Solar. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir, can you just brief about the company, about your vision and mission of Sova Solar?
Sova Solar is a company which is dedicated to the green energy cause. Actually, it's a dream project of my father. Our family has been in the business for last 3.5 decades, and we have been in various sectors such as steel and mining. And then in 2010, my father, he wanted to come into the solar industry because of the love for nature and also for the hope that it would bring something good to the society. So that is our vision and mission, to energize the future and make a clean and green, pollution-free world.
So what are the achievements of Sova Solar and the projects undertaken and the innovations of Sova Solar yet?
You see, last 10 years that we are in this business, we have grown from a relatively small company to a substantial company in India's solar space. And as of now, in technical developments, what we have achieved is we are giving world-class standard products, and now we are going ahead with the AC modules, which is coming up. It's under development. We have commercially launched the monopark modules, and also what I would like to showcase is because of the quality that we have maintained. In the first half of this year alone, our plant capacity for this year has been fully booked, and we are grateful to our customers who have reposed faith on us over the years. And as a testimony to the quality that we undertake, in the last several years, last 10 years, what we have done is around 300 megawatts of solar module sales we have done, and the amount of replacement that we had to give is negligibly small. It's actually less than 1 megawatt. So that is the level of commitment that we have towards quality, which helps us to deliver to our clients world-class products at a sustainable price, and which gives us and our customers the benefit that they want to stay with us for the longer run.
Can you further enlighten us on the products and its technology, and as well as the pricing roadmap of your products?
See, regarding the products, last year we were in here in REI, we had launched this monopark and 1500 volt modules. Now it's under full commercial deployment. We are doing 1500 volts, we are doing the monopark. But albeit the monopark demand in India is per se is little bit less, but we are trying to promote it. And the second thing, which is a new revolution I believe is coming, is for the AC modules, which would substantially reduce the BOS costs going ahead, because the inverter would be left redundant in case that modules directly generate BOS, directly generate the AC electricity. And regarding the price component, what I understand from the trends going ahead is that in the last 10 years, what we have seen is that the multi prices have fallen by around, fallen to around 20% of the 2010 levels, and the mono prices have fallen to a level of around 25%. And I believe that still further some reduction in prices are going to happen, which would bring more and more inclusiveness to the market. And with the grace of God and the support of the government, we believe that solar is going to have a huge opportunity in the years coming ahead.
And we really achieve 100 gigawatt by 2022, like what's the challenges we can face?
You see, today what we have seen is that India has already installed something north of 20 gigawatt, and this year the target is 12 gigawatt, and I believe that it's certainly achievable target. and the way the projects that are coming up now in the pipeline, there's around 20 or 25 gigawatt of projects that have been done. The PPAs are under signing and finalization stage. So I believe that if we can go at this pace, which is certainly a possibility, then 100 gigawatt by 2022 wouldn't be such a big deal. We would be able to achieve this one. But certainly there are some challenges, and the most important of them is the financial health of the DISCOMs and also the financial health of all the companies that are associated with the solar industry, because this industry has seen a massive cutthroat competition in the recent past, and so everyone is very, very shaky. But I believe that the government must be coming out with some policies which would be helpful in stabilizing this industry, and this would be one of the pillars of the Indian economy.
So lastly, what would you say about EQ Magazine, as we have completed 10 years? So a few words for EQ Magazine.
So first of all, congratulations for the successful 10 years. And EQ Magazine has been a friend, a partner with Sova Solar since the very beginning. And I wish you all the very success for years to come.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for being with us. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.